So the new shots are the first real updates that we've had to the COVID-19 vaccine since they were originally introduced in the late period of 2020. So all of the vaccines that we've gotten up to this point, whether they were the primary series or booster doses, were the same type of vaccine. And that was built off the original strain of the SARS-CoV-2 virus. The key difference between that vaccine and the most recent vaccines is that the new ones are what they call a bivalent vaccine, which means they have components of both the original strain of SARS-CoV-2 virus, as well as the Omicron subvariants that are known as BA4 and BA5. And since those are the predominantly strains that are circulating worldwide, particularly BA5, it's felt that this newer vaccine will be one that offers better protection and longer lasting immunity. And it's called a bivalent vaccine because it has those two components. One is the original strain and one is the new subvariants of Omicron. Yes, you're eligible for the bivalent booster. In fact, it is the only vaccine you should get as a booster dose. The monovalent vaccine is still available, but it really is only for individuals who have never had the COVID vaccine. So it would be what they call the primary series that they should get as their first two doses. The FDA has authorized and the CDC has recommended that you wait at least 2 months after your most recent booster dose before you receive the bivalent vaccine. Yes, you actually do have some protection. It's in fact, we know from previous studies with other variants of COVID vaccine or COVID that you have some natural immunity from a previous infection. And that's one of the reasons why they recommend waiting up for an interval of time before you receive a booster dose. In this case, the CDC is recommending you wait at least 3 months at minimum between your recent COVID infection and receiving the bivalent vaccine. So if you've recently had an infection, the CDC recommends you wait at least 3 months before you receive the bivalent vaccine booster. However, you could wait longer. As with most vaccines, you never want to take a vaccine shorter than that interval or sooner than is recommended, but you can always take it later than is recommended. And in some cases, there may be some benefits to actually getting that booster at a later time. Well, with many vaccines, to include COVID, immunologic studies have shown if you extend that interval between doses, you can actually improve the immune response, as well as maybe the duration of protection. It's certainly felt that in some cases, extending that interval, in this case, from say 2 to 3 months to something like 4 to 6 months, may give you longer lasting protection because it increases the number of neutralizing antibodies, which are the antibodies that actually target the pathogen, in this case, the SARS-CoV-2 virus. And it also increases the activity of B cells and T cells, which are part of our immune system. So B cells and T cells are parts of our immune system. They are actually white blood cells. And B cells actually produce the antibodies that people know about. And antibodies really are the ones that target those pathogens, whether it's bacteria or viruses or even toxins in some cases. T cells actually attack other cells that are infected with those pathogens. And so really they're both a part of our comprehensive immune system that helps protect us from disease. So hyperactive immunity is just a general term for an overactive immune state. And that can happen with certain diseases, but it also can happen with a normal response to either an infection or a normal response to a vaccination. And what it implies is there's a sort of a plateau or a high level of effectiveness of our immune system. So if you're in a hyperimmune state, there's probably limited benefit to getting another vaccine dose. It really doesn't add to the ability to respond more quickly. It doesn't provide a longer response. However, if you come out of that hyperimmune state, which often happens with a longer interval between doses, that next booster dose really has a greater effect to enhance our immune system response, therefore give greater protection, and could last longer as well in your system to protect you against disease.